coming on Friday. And then the clothes fall on. 'Cause it's just minutes and highways. Oh, until the one I love, the one I love. So,
eternal God, creator and preserver of all life, author of salvation, giver of all grace, bless and sanctify with your Holy Spirit, Evan and Kate. We come now to join in marriage. Grant that they may give their vows to each other in the strength of your steadfast love. Enable them to grow in love. Today is the day that brings two families together, a husband and wife. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, those whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder. Amen. You may kiss your bride.
I'm hurting, baby. I'm broken down. I need your loving, loving. I need it now. When I'm without you, I'm something weak.
So there comes a time in everyone's life when they meet that one special person. Their best friend, their soulmate. The person that they want to spend the rest of their life with. And for this big guy right over here, that moment came 15 years ago when he met me. Right? So for those of you who don't know me, my name is Jacob Richard, a longtime friend and fraternity brother of Evans. I'd like to begin tonight just by first thanking everyone who was able to come out this evening. It means a lot to Evan and Kate for you to be here on their big day. Also, a big thank you to the parents of the bride and groom, to Patrick and Laura. Thank you both so much for helping make this day become reality. And also, of course, for raising this beautiful woman that Evan gets to call his wife right now. Pretty cool. And then to Scott and Michelle, who have put up with me longer than you probably care to. But also thank you for helping make this day happen and doing, well, you did what you could with Evan. So Evan and I met back in grade school, and we have been close friends ever since. And in the time that I've known Evan, we've done enough things, have enough experience and stories to probably write a book. Everything from playing sports together, traveling around the country. We've even driven across the state of Kansas, no joke here, with enough explosives to start a world war. And from all these experiences, I've learned a few things about Evan. Well, actually, I've learned a lot of things about him. A few of which I'll grace with you tonight. So Evan is a repository of useless information. I've always told him that if I'm ever on a game show and I have a phone a friend, Evan is going to be the first guy that I call.
Here, here.
Evan is a little clumsy. I've seen him fall downstairs, I've seen him walk through screen doors. I've even seen him almost blow his head off from a vinegar pump. I've learned that you never rush Evan in the bathroom. If you do, he's literally just going to tell you greatness takes time. But antics aside, Evan is a real stand-up guy. He's always up for anything. He's patient, he's kind, he's loving, pretty smart, and he's extremely rational, which I can tell you is a great thing to have in a friend, by the way. But above all, he's always, always there for me. In 15 years that I've known Evan, not once has he ever left my side or had my back. He's one of the most dependable guys I know. But enough about him, let's talk about this beautiful woman sitting next to him. Kate, I gotta say, you look absolutely gorgeous this evening.
You're here.
Yeah. Actually, I'd like to take a quick poll with our audience here. So we're going to start with the ladies first. Ladies, if you think Mrs. It's got a good ring to it. If you think Mrs. Hamm looks absolutely incredible tonight, can I get a woo? Looks fantastic tonight. Can I get a Yeah? And I got one more, Taylor. What do you think? There we go. And don't worry, Michelle, we were talking about you too there. Okay, I cannot be more happy that you're the woman marrying Evan. I've known from the day I met you that you are absolutely the woman of Evan's dreams. You are beautiful inside and out. You're caring, you're loving, highly, highly intelligent. Notice I said a little intelligent for Evan, highly, highly. But she's super organized. In fact, Kate told me that I only had 3 minutes to give this toast. I think I've already busted that. But she told me that if I shower her with compliments and I embarrass Evan just a little bit, that I could buy myself another minute. So can I have one more minute? Okay. So I remember the day that Evan told me he was going to propose to Kate, and I felt extremely happy knowing that he was going to be able to marry this wonderful woman sitting next to him. And then I remember when he told me how he was going to propose to Kate, and I started laughing. Because if you know Evan, then you know the idea of him proposing in front of 50,000 people, smack dab in the middle of one of the loudest stadiums in the country. You say, that sounds a little crazy, right? But when I thought about it a little more, I realized that when you put Kate into the equation, it's not so crazy. You see, I think Kate and Evan's relationship is a prime example of synergy, where 1 + 1 = 3, where the sum of the parts together is greater than the individual sums themselves. And I think it could be more true in this case, where you have Evan and Kate, and together they create this unbreakable bond of two wonderful people who love each other very much. So if we could all raise a glass, here's to Evan and Kate, the synergies within their relationship, the love this entire room has for this couple, and of course, for their very, very successful future together. Love you guys.
And we have been through a lot together, most notably our braces and acne phase, which unfortunately coincided with our obsession with taking selfies. But we've come a long way. And one thing I've always loved and admired about Kate is that she dreams big, and she knows what she wants, and she goes after it, no matter what other people say, she doesn't care. And one example I have of this is in ninth grade. Kate decided that instead of shortening her full name of Catherine to Kate, she wanted to go by Rin. She changed her Facebook name and everything. And another time, as her senior year of high school, she decided she wanted to double major in elementary education and astrophysics, teach elementary kids about the planets. And I can give you countless other examples. Most of them I knew was probably going to make a funny story in the future or just be in the Kate phase. There's one other example that I knew pretty quickly probably wasn't just a phase, and that was that Kate decided she wanted to date Evan Hamm. So Kate and I went to separate colleges, and the summer after freshman year we were both back in Olathe hanging out all summer like we always do. And all I heard about was how cute this boy named Evan was. And she was, they would text a lot, and she really liked him, but he just wasn't committing, he wasn't sure. You know, Kate was determined, and lo and behold, soon after that summer, they started dating, and here we are on the wedding day, and I cannot be happier for these two. They make a great couple. Proud to say that Evan is one of Kate's biggest supporters of her dreams now. And Kate and I are in separate cities. I know our friendship will remain as strong as ever. And like I said, I'm so excited for you too. I can't wait to see where life brings you. And I'd like to present a toast to Mr. and Mrs. Hamm. Your love is an inspiration to all of us. And keep dreaming big. To Kate and Evan.
Baby, I think I wanna marry you.